It seems some kind of a breakthrough with the doctors doing a climb down on this demand for a live telecast, agreeing to, you know, minutes of the meeting being recorded. Now, the question is, when will this meeting take place? The invitation was for 5 p.m. today.
Well, it's 5 p.m. and what we've been given to understand is the doctors still haven't left from the protest site. So even if they come here, it'll take them another half an hour to 45 at least, if that is, if they leave right now. And obviously, there is what's been agreed to is that minutes of the meeting will be exchanged and signed by both sides. Now, as far as transcripts go, there are, you know, the government, of course, is used to, you know, minutes of meetings being taken, and they have people taking minutes. But obviously, what we are being given to understand is that the doctors want to bring someone from their side who will do the stenography or, you know, taking down the minutes of the meeting. So in that context, obviously, if there's further issues, we'll have to wait and watch as to how, what transpires. The timing for the meeting that was given today was 5 p.m. The chief secretary has already sent a mail saying that minutes of the meeting will be noted and also signed by both parties and exchanged. But the doctors are yet to arrive here. 5 p.m. was the time, so we don't know what time they will arrive here. And, you know, again, whether, you know, the meeting will actually take place or not. I mean, we've gotten used to them coming and then, of course, the meeting not happening. But however, today that climb down on that major, you know, sort of bone of contention, which was that live streaming or videography of that entire meeting, on that there has been resolution of sorts. So before the Supreme Court hearing tomorrow on Tuesday, what we see is some sort of an attempt, last and fifth and final attempt, as the state government puts it, to bring the protesting doctors back to work through dialogue.
That's right, and sort of this comes, you know, ahead of the Supreme Court hearing. That's also key because we do know the doctors have not followed what the Supreme Court had ordered them, which was to return to their duties. And this is the fifth and final time that Mamata Banerjee has called them for these talks. So tomorrow the hearing, interesting that they do this climb down on the eve of the Supreme Court hearing.
I mean, the climb down actually, if actually takes note, happened on Saturday, but by then it was too late. And then, of course, you know, today there was another invite sent to them, and they should be on their way. But whether they will come or not is something that's still not known, because they've still not left from there. It seems that they will come, but it'll take some time. 5 o'clock, meanwhile, was the time for the meeting, and obviously, you know, it's past five already. So perhaps it'll take some more time for them to come, and it'll be a little delayed, slightly delayed, before the meeting actually gets underway, if it does get underway this time. Meanwhile, tomorrow, like you said, yes, is the Supreme Court hearing, and what we are hearing is that Indra Jaisingh, senior lawyer, you know, in the Supreme Court, will be representing the doctors. But again, that is something that we'll see. And in that context, obviously, you know, if there is no breakthrough today, then perhaps the final, you know, sort of solution in this case, a final sort of resolving of this deadlock, would perhaps require, you know, one more time the intervention of the Supreme Court.
All right, Saurabh, thanks so much for joining us with that. And we're waiting for more clarity on whether the doctors are coming for that meeting from the protest site. So we'll continue to update you on that. But let's go across to Tanushka now for more. And Tanushka, today we saw that the lawyers, I beg your pardon, the doctors had actually come to Delhi and held a press conference, you know, one part of the protesting doctors, and they spoke about their various demands. So what are the demands now as they go into this meeting with Mamata Banerjee?
Right, Gargi, the first and foremost demand that the doctors lay, other than, of course, for justice in this rape and murder case, is that of transparency, transparency of dialogue, and as well as the investigation. They want to, you know, have a look at these CBI reports, what the CBI has been investigating. The doctors said that it has been over a month since the case is being investigated into. However, there has been no swift or conclusive action that has been taken as of yet, not from the CBI's end, neither from the Supreme Court's end. This is what the doctors are at this point claiming. And we know that the former principal of the RJ Corps Medical College and Hospital, Sandeep Ghosh, has been recently charged with the rape and murder crime as well. However, the doctors continue reiterating about the transparency, and what we are understanding right now, Saurabh also mentioned, is that their main demands were from live streaming, it came down to minutes of the meeting being recorded or videography permissions given from both sides. So at this point, what we know is from the chief minister's end that minutes of the meeting permission for that has been given. Here, the doctors who were present, not just from the West Bengal Doctors Front, but also from the RDAs across Delhi, they were on the same stance that if these two conditional requests are also not met with respect to the minutes of the meeting and the videography permissions, then they will not go into the meeting. Clarity is still awaited on whether or not this delegation of doctors in Kolkata will go ahead into this fifth meeting with the chief minister or not. The other demands remain of the resignation or the removal of the commissioner of police in Kolkata, Vineet Goyal, the resignation removal of the director of health, the health secretary. So these are some demands that are there, apart from, of course, ensuring a robust security system, implementation of an internal complaints committee, a gender audit to be done, not just in Bengal, but also in hospitals across the country, so that there is pure understanding of what is the percentage, what is the male-female ratio working in these hospitals. Because what these doctors have also claimed is that majority are women working in hospitals across the country. This is not just in Bengal, but this is something that Delhi RDAs have also raised. So all in all, what the Delhi Resident Doctors Associations, even the AIIMS Doctors Associations for AIIMS across the country, maintain their solid support and solidarity with the West Bengal Doctors Front. And what they remain on is that if the Supreme Court does not come out with a favorable hearing tomorrow, then they will continue with their strike and they will continue to be in support with the West Bengal Doctors Front.